without bulking, then stay tuned and put on some serious mass. YouTube, it's Stephen here from Carter Fitness and Nutrition. So this video is based on, do you need to bulk to put on muscle? Okay, so first of all, what is bulking? Bulking is where you increase your calories over your maintenance. So basically your maintenance is the amount of calories you eat to maintain your weight. So depending on your activity level, of course, will depend on what your overall maintenance calories will be. Same with your BMI, you know, metabolic rate, everything like that. So you need to increase your calories over your maintenance. So you basically eat more than you burn in a day. So that's you bulking. Otherwise, the opposite is a deficit, where you are eating less than your maintenance, where you are burning more than you consume. Okay, so that's like 500 calories below maintenance, for example, which is a pound a week that you burn the body fat. So, do I believe that you should bulk to add muscle? No. Bulking is only necessary in certain periods. So basically, you only need to bulk if you, one, you have low body fat. So your body fat's low, where your energy is just crashing. Okay, so that's where you, yeah, I would agree that you need to bulk. Like if you're like 4, 5, 6, 7% and you can't maintain that year long, then yes, push yourself up to 10%, maybe above that. Another way is obviously bulking is if your metabolism is off the through the roof and you need to increase your calories because your body is constantly burning those calories through, well, general need, whatever you do throughout the day. Okay, so that is another reason you should bulk. So, which obviously the first one comes in where you're competing as well. You know, you've just finished a show. You need to bulk after that. You can't maintain 4-5% year long, like we mentioned before. But yeah, your body is fully capable of putting on muscle on maintenance and in a caloric deficit. And how? As long as you've got adequate amount of protein, you are drinking enough water, and you have enough energy throughout the day, like from carbohydrates and caffeine, you are fully capable of putting on muscle mass. So yeah, that's basically. Obviously you don't need to bulk, that's scientifically proven. I used to bulk years ago, so basically I used to eat way more than I should consume. So I was a 220 pound guy at my very most. Now, not normally for me, when I competed back in April, I was 162 pounds. So it shows what bulking can really do. So I had severe body dysmorphia, and really in my opinion, it's really not worth it. You want to have a body where you can maintain for the rest of your life, sort of like a good body fat range, a good amount of muscle mass, something you're happy with. And you're not going to be happy if you're fat and you just don't look right. If you like to have bicep veins, you don't look nice, then of course, well, you just want to maintain a healthy lifestyle, really. And bulking really isn't that. So yeah, that's what I think, obviously, because I've been there. I've obviously had that sort of body dysmorphia. Obviously I had it post after the show as well, but that's completely different. That's from looking completely shredded, which I'll go over on another video, of course. So yeah,
this is what we used to look like when we bulked back during lockdown in 2020. We were in a 1,000 calorie surplus, believing the eat big get big myth, and being honest, looking back at that proves what bulking can result in.
Yeah, that's my experience for bulking. I did it for a very long time. I ate 4,000 calories, so I was basically eating 1,300 calories surplus. And that's why I used to believe eating more means gaining more, which really doesn't. The majority of that is body fat or muscle mass. That's what a lot of people have got to understand, is bulk and cut doesn't have to happen. You can just maintain a healthy body fat year long and slowly put on muscle from there. That's what I believe. So, and that's what I'm doing currently, and being honest, I'm very happy with that. I'm very happy with staying lean off season, and then when I go back into competing again, which I'll be, well, we'll be prepping again in April the 1st, Then obviously that's when we cut down a bit. Obviously I'm only 11% body fat at this current moment, so I'm not really having to cut down dramatically. I think, in my opinion, bulking, not worth your time. Definitely not worth your time. Just eat healthy, because bulking a lot of time means eating a lot of junk food that you really don't want to put that in your system. You don't want to increase your sodium, you don't want to increase your cholesterol. That's the least thing you want to do. You want to eat healthy, choose the low calorie dense foods, feel fuller for longer. That is how you should live, as in, yeah, healthy lifestyle. So yeah, just stick to your maintenance, eat in a caloric deficit if you really need to, and just stay healthy and stay happy. That's what I think. Hope you learned a lot from this video about bulking. Of course, it's not necessary, so you've got a brief answer here. Obviously scientifically proven. Do your research if you need, if you don't believe me, but you don't need to bulk to put on muscle. It's an excuse for most people to eat food. That's my opinion. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and subscribe. Please look on Instagram, CarterFitness90, and I hope you enjoyed the video.